The White House without Hope. The president's close confidant, Hope Hicks, left the administration this week, leaving many to wonder who might fill that void as President Trump appears increasingly emboldened. My next guest claims insight in this area, having talked to the president for a new book. It's out on Tuesday. It's called The Trump White House, Changing the Rules of the Game. And here with me for an exclusive preview is author Ronald Kessler. Congratulations on the book. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having
me. So your book defends the president on a number of fronts, including the Russia investigation, Access Hollywood, talks about his marriage, how it's clearly going to last. It repeatedly attacks the press. I want to get to some of the scoops in it in a second. But as a larger theme, how should people read it? Is it meant as a defense of President Trump?
I think it's a truthful book, and it says that he will be seen as a great president, just like Reagan, who was dissed by the press based on the results. You know, the record unemployment, getting rid of ISIS, all these tweets and controversies are going to be forgotten long term. But at the same time, there's plenty of negative items in the book and juicy tidbits in the book. For example, Hope Hicks is the number one leaker, and she...
Hope Hicks or Kellyanne Conway?
I'm sorry, Kellyanne.
Yeah, Kellyanne Conway, in the book.
While I was interviewing Kellyanne at the White House, she forgot that she was on the record, and she started lashing into Reince Priebus. She said the most mean, cutting, and obviously untrue things about Reince, and I didn't include them in the book because they were so unfair. She also led into Jared and Ivanka, saying that they leak against Steve Bannon. I know that White House aides have seen texts that she has sent to other journalists, dissing her colleagues, leaking material. So if you wonder, you know, why there are so many leaks out of the White House, one reason is Kellyanne is the number one leaker.
A defender of Kellyanne might say that you clearly interviewed, in addition to her for the book, you clearly interviewed Bannon and Priebus and Spicer, and maybe it is other people who are saying that about her. But instead of getting into the weeds on Kellyanne, I want to ask you about some of the other scoops in the book.
Yeah, but this was actually an interview that I had with her,
right,
in which she dissed Reince Priebus and Jared and Ivanka. So there was no question about the veracity of what was happening.
I want to ask you about your view of some of the other people around the president. Mm-hmm. You say about daughter Ivanka and son-in-law Jared Kushner, you call them Teflon aides. You write, quote, "In the end, Jared and Ivanka would push the most disastrous and foolish decisions of Trump's presidency. They had no understanding of how the basic fundamentals of how government works, how a campaign works, how politics works. Most of all, they had no understanding of the political consequences of their actions." What are some of the recommendations they made that you're talking about?
They pushed the firing of Comey, which was disastrous. It brought in the special counsel, Mueller.
Why did they do that? Why did Jared Kushner push that?
Jared said, well, the Democrats will love this. This was a political move. And of course, it turned out not to be true at all. In addition, they pushed hiring Anthony Scaramucci, who had to be the most absurd hire in the history of the White House. So Donald Trump understands that they are problems, has said to them, maybe you should go back to New York, implied that he really didn't want them. But, you know, he doesn't fire people. He certainly is not going to fire a family member. So they remain the Teflon aides.
Yeah, you have a note on page 139. You say, despite his persona on The Apprentice, Donald Trump almost never fires anyone himself. Instead, he makes their lives miserable. One person he's clearly not going to fire, you write about quite a bit, is the First Lady, Melania Trump. You write that she has tremendous impact on policy and strategy, sitting in on key meetings. Here's what former Press Secretary Sean Spicer told you in an interview about the First Lady, quote, "She is a very powerful behind-the-scenes force. I don't think people fully recognize how influential she is and what a grounded political sense she has on her own. She always seems to have the pulse on the right move and the right person at the right time. When she weighs in, it's always spot on." How specifically has Melania swayed the president on any specific issues?
Well, for one thing, she got him to run. He was sort of pussyfooting around about running, and she said, you know, you have to declare your candidacy. And that's what happened, and he went up in the polls. But beyond that, she will disagree with him. She'll sit in meetings with cabinet officers, and she'll disagree with Trump. Her judgment is spectacular. And we have pictures of her as well, which will certainly sell a book.
And you've also, in terms of Hope Hicks, I want to ask you about her. Her last day at the White House was on Thursday. She's been one of his closest aides. You write, quote, Donald Trump has told friends that billionaires are constantly asking him to fix them up with Hicks, who's consumed by her work and until recently was never seen with a date. Trump says he refuses. Beyond her dating life, how do you think the White House is going to be without her there? A lot of people think that she has been a real stabilizing force for the president because they've been so close and she's been with him for so long.
You know, she actually pushed the book, I call it a novel, by Michael Wolff, along with Steve Bannon. So I don't think that shows that her judgment is that wonderful. You know, everyone loves her. She's very enthusiastic about Trump. But to me, that is not a good sign.
All right, Ron Kessler, thank you so much for being here. The book is called The Trump White House, Changing the Rules of the Game. I should just note, as a journalist, I kind of take issue with some of your criticism of fellow journalists, but good luck with the book. We appreciate your being here. Happy Passover and happy Easter to you
happy
and your family.
Passover.
Appreciate it.